टीसी नंबर 316, 5 सेकेंड स्टार्ट। सर, एग्रीकल्चर इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट बिकॉज 75% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ दिस कंट्री इज रूरल एंड डिपेंडेंट ऑन एग्रीकल्चर। आई शैल ब्रीफली टच अपॉन द अचीवमेंट्स इन द एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर इन द पास्ट 64 ईयर्स। दिस कैन बी गज्ड फ्रॉम द फैक्ट दैट बोथ इंडिया एंड चाइना हैव द सेम एरिया ऑफ कल्टिवेबल लैंड विच कम्स टू अबाउट 14 करोड़ हेक्टेयर्स। आई वुड लाइक टू ड्रॉ द अटेंशन ऑफ द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर towards the fact that China is producing 45 crore tons of food grains while India's production has been between 18 and 19 crore tons in the last 3-4 years. This means there are certain reasons as a result of which our production is low. Sir, I would like to inform the House that agriculture contributes 33%, industries 29% and other services 38% to the national income. The contribution of agriculture can be easily raised to 50% in the national income. The main reasons for low national income are the wrong policies and their faulty implementation by the government. To increase the national income, we must raise the contribution of agriculture to 50%. Sir, I would like the Agriculture Ministry to note that irrigation and fertilizers play a key role in increasing agricultural production. Sir, so far as irrigation projects are concerned, out of all the projects planned in the post-independence period, about 200 big and medium projects were undertaken. At the end of these 64 years, only 65 projects have been completed and 2300 big dams have been constructed and 1800 dams are yet to be constructed. But even in this age of science and technology, 70% of the water and these dams get evaporated. Sir, fortunately, our country has been blessed with great natural wealth. Underground water is also available in abundance and can be utilized best to encourage irrigation through tube wells in North India. The maximum credit of the achievement made in this regard so far goes to the farmers. Electricity is the basic necessity to meet irrigation requirement. I need not say much about the state of electricity throughout the country, particularly in Uttar Pradesh, which is the most backward state in the country. Therefore, my submission is that unless we increase the power generation, we cannot solve the problems. Mr. Chairman, sir, through you, I would like to submit to the Honorable Minister of Agriculture that it is a matter of disadvantage for us to continue the projects in hand for a long period because the expenditure goes on increasing every year. The result is that the expenditure increases twice as compared to the initial cost. It creates a number of difficulties and the work of the projects comes to a standstill for a long period. In Uttar Pradesh, several projects have been lying incomplete due to the non-cooperation of the central government. In this connection, I would like to urge the Honorable Minister of Agriculture that the central government should provide funds for these projects in time so that the projects are completed and the farmers get irrigation facilities and also the production of food grains in the country may increase. Mr. Chairman, Sir, I would also like to submit that according to our experts, at least 33% of the total land should be covered by forest. But due to continuous denudation during the last 64 years, presently only 6% of the total area is covered by forest. It is only agriculture which has been suffering. Soil erosion is on the increase and affecting agriculture. I would like to submit to the Honorable Minister of Agriculture that all these things are related to agriculture. Therefore, the government should pay attention to it and take measures to encourage afforestation. Mr. Chairman, Sir, I would like to draw the attention of the members of the House to a matter to which very few members have drawn our attention. But I consider it is a very important issue. We are fortunate that in Olympic Games we failed to win even a bronze medal, what to talk of gold. What is the cause behind it? The reason is that 75% of the population living in rural areas remains deprived of milk. 40% of the rural children crave even for a drop of milk other than their mother's milk. I would like to submit to the Honorable Minister of Agriculture that I would not like to go into the details of what the government have done for the poor people so far and what they would do in future, but I would submit that fortunately the cattle in rural areas of the country are taken care of like other members of the family. Therefore, we need not impart any training in animal husbandry. The cow, which gives only 1 liter milk today, can give 20 liter milk if the government improves the breed.